banks and financial institutions are more and more worried about regulatory expectations, because regulations are becoming more and more strict, not only because of frauds, cyber frauds, but also because of, you know, the frauds which are non-cyber. And the bank, the central bank wants to know what banks are doing. And the central bank wants to make sure the banks are doing well, they are not reporting their figures improperly, and you know, they want to keep tabs on the efficiency and productivity of the banks and whether they are doing risk management. So RegTech is becoming more and more important. Like things like regulatory reporting, anti-money laundering, things like that.
Right. So if we talk a little bit about the Indian market, I mean, is the RegTech evolving because the regulations here are stricter than anywhere else?
So in India, you know, this concept called ADF, it started in around 2013, where central bank wanted banks to report to them a lot of data about themselves through non-manual intervention. They wanted all the reports to come to RBI in a very automated way. So they started with ADF. After a couple of years, this anti-money laundering, you know, became very important because of all the terrorist activity happening. And the government thought that if terrorist activity has to be reduced, then the funding to them has to be reduced. So they wanted to catch hold of, you know, any suspicious transactions which might be, you know, involving laundering of money. So anti-money laundering became very popular. It became mandatory for every bank to implement anti-money laundering. Now the whole anti-money laundering, of course, remains, and it has to become real time. But now the fraud risk management, that is becoming more and more important, because the frauds can need not be only about anti-money laundering, but frauds can be about various kinds. So the frauds have to be detected on time and, you know, prevented. So that is also
important. Right. So you know, talking a little bit, you know, going deeper into the RegTech, how is Nelito, you know, enabling banks to combat these kind of frauds?
So Nelito has been in the regulatory reporting area for the last 6 years. We have implemented so-called ADF system in India and in Mauritius and around 15 banks. And there are hundreds of reports which have to go from the banks to RBI and the central bank every month, every week, every day. So Nelito is enabling that. Now the whole game is evolving to sort of like pull-based reports. No, so earlier ADF was like push-based reporting. The banks were pushing their reports to RBI. Now RBI says, don't push. We will pull whatever we want. So they are coming up with a new standard called CIMS, SIMS, which is more like a pull-based regulatory report. So the whole game, every bank will have to migrate from ADF to SIMS.
Is that already happening?
Well, in the in RBI, the SIMS implementation is happening. I think it will get over in around 1 year. And then every bank will have to implement the same thing at their end. So that is happening on that side. We also have you know, a small anti-money laundering solution, which we are improving. We are partners with DTS of Japan now. They hold 100% equity in Nelito now. They have a product for anti-money laundering, which we want to improve and make it relevant for the markets in Asia.
So which are your focus markets, and how do you see 2020? I mean, do you have any targets that you can share with us?
So in 2020, we want to, you know, strengthen our presence in countries like Cambodia and Myanmar and Mauritius, where we started some action last year. We also want to get into some newer markets in East Africa and Middle East, and also in countries like Laos and Indonesia. Indian market seems to be quite slow right now, but there are some niche areas which are very promising.
So, if we can talk a little bit about how the future of fintech is looking like in the coming year.
So fintech is actually, you know, when we talk of fintech in Nelito, we think more of lending. So fintech, the name fintech conjures in the mind an image of, you know, sort of giving a loan in 2 minutes without any human intervention. So while that is possible, but I think what really matters is, you know, how do you reduce the time without reducing the risk? I mean, without increasing the risk.
Right.
So you have to take decisions faster, but using data, you have to make it more and more risk-free.
Right.
Which means, you know, that is the key, using data and analytics. How do you capture the risk of the borrower better, so that your risk of default is reduced? At the same time, you give loan faster and faster.
So now you spoke about digital lending, and the Indian market is pretty much, you know, is currently saturated with a lot of digital lending players have come into this space. But with the liquidity crunch that's in the market, how does technology, you know, help these companies so that, you know, we don't face those kind of issues that has cropped up in the past few months?
So one is, you know, the whole slowdown in the NBFC and microfinance sector which we are seeing is because of, you know, all the frauds which might have happened. And because of the fraud, the banks are not lending to the NBFC sector. So now how can frauds be caught before they are caught?
Yeah.
So that's where the RegTech and anti-money laundering come into picture, and the fraud reduction technologies come into picture. How do you detect frauds before they happen? Technology plays a very important part. So that is on prevention part. But you know, in the days of slowdown, you need to do more with less. So technology helps you do more with less.
Right.
You know, how do you reach more customers with lesser money, in lesser time? How do you go to areas which are like very, very remote and reach customers who are very remote in rural areas where normally banks don't go? Technology enables that also. So these are the things which technology can make you do. And so it makes you more productive, it makes you more agile, it makes you more flexible.
So what is the biggest challenge in front of you, and that you want to overcome?
So right now, if I talk about my customers, my biggest challenge is to make them more agile, more flexible, and more productive. And also, you know, use the data which they have to help them get more insight into their own customers, so that they can upsell and cross-sell to their own customers. The challenge which I have for my own company is to, you know, how to sort of do well in this days of slowdown, how to get more customers.
Thank you so much for talking to us, Mr. Jain. It's a pleasure.
Thanks, Priyanka. It's a pleasure talking to you.